I sense that we're coming to some major defining moment in our history. And I think those people who are meant to unfold through this are unfolding and doing it pretty rapidly. You know, how many people get up in the morning and roll out of bed and the first thought is about what work they're going to do today or shopping or whatever it is they're meant to be doing, and they don't fully engage with the moment. You know, they throw the breakfast down while they're reading the newspaper or having a cigarette or coffee or whatever it may be, but they're not truly connecting to the experience. If you take a look around you, if you take a look at global warming, terrorism, poverty, all these kinds of things, and what we're doing to the planet, the question has to arise, how much longer is this sustainable?
Atmospheric levels of CO2 are reaching catastrophic levels.
How much longer can it keep on going? There are many ways in which this whole deck of cards, which is the matrix in which we live, many ways in which this could just topple tomorrow. Now in England, for example, we import the vast majority of our food. We have £1.1 trillion worth of personal debt. We import oil, you know. And we're dependent on oil still. Of course, globally, we're all interconnected. Every single event has a knock-on effect everywhere else. So we only need one event of quite major proportions, and all of this could just come tumbling down.
A collapse on Wall Street today has sent share and house prices plummeting.
Queues for medicine and food are full.
And then where do we get our food from, our fuel from, our heating, our lighting? It's all a possibility. And the question is, how are we unfolding through that? What is our transition through that? It's interesting in 2004 when the tsunami happened in Asia, how no animals, or very few, were caught up in the tsunami. Maybe they were tuned into the consciousness of the universe in a way that we've become disconnected from. Well, when I tune in, I feel a tsunami is coming, and it's telling me very clearly how to change my life in order to prepare for that, to become more self-sustaining, to become more at one with Mother Earth. It's telling me to go inwards, to let go of my attachment to this external drama, and in so doing really connect with my soul and follow that guidance wherever it wishes to take me. This is perhaps the defining moment of the spiritual journey, which causes people then to question the validity of the story that they've been told about reality all this time, and question all of that programming and conditioning. At this point, the person on the journey tends to sort of ask, well, what is this all about? And there might come at that point a letting go, a giving up of trying to shape the external drama. So this surrender quietens the internal mechanisms down. It stills the thoughts to a degree, or calms the emotions. And then consciousness, which has been sucked up and identified in those processes, can be released. and open outwards into new layers of experience. Where we're reconnecting to unity consciousness, that which unites us all. But specifically, we're reconnecting to the soul, which is our unique expression of that unity consciousness. And those experiences are typified frequently by a feeling of expansion, timelessness, awesome stillness, peace, a sense of at one with all things. They've had a taste of this something which can give them what they've been seeking all their lives, and they found it inside themselves, and it's a sense of completeness. And classically, there's a belief that this is enlightenment. But in fact, it's really just the beginning of the story. What I believe is there's an acceleration. I see people making transitions rapidly. And that's in tune, that's in line with an acceleration in consciousness of the universe. Our planetary system is moving to a higher vibrational reality based on unconditional love, joy, and mutual respect for all life. And we're being invited to join them. We're being offered this incredible gift, a blessing. And how do we get there? The key is to go inwards and to recognize that in every moment we have a choice. We can either attune to the density, to the difficulty, to the harshness, to the problems that we are witnessing around us right now, or instead we can attune to the lightness, the joy, the love, the at one with all things. And if we do that, we're taking on a pathway internally through layers of consciousness, what you might call gateways of light. It's our journey of ascension. It's our destiny. But the real secret is surrender. Letting go to what is, because the universe has a design, a natural process all of its own. It's breathed out and formed the universe, and now it's breathing back in again. And if we just let go and surrender, we can attune to that flow back to higher levels of unity and degree of oneness, like a surfer riding a wave. We don't dictate the way the wave goes, we just ride it and enjoy the ride.